Hello and welcome to the Building Blocks of Jazz. Today we're coming to you for the very first time from the Centene Jazz Education Center, the brand new facility of Jazz St. Louis. Now today we're going to look at a topic called jazz influences. We're going to look specifically at how jazz music has influenced many classical composers and how classical music has influenced many jazz musicians and composers. In 1922, the French classical composer Darius Milhaud took a trip to New York to explore jazz after hearing his very first American jazz band. It was there on the streets of Harlem that he got a taste of what he called authentic jazz. He was so influenced by these elements of blues and swing that he began composing in a new style he called jazz idiom. In 1923, he composed a work entitled La Création du Monde, which demonstrates these very distinct influences. When the American violinist Paul Whiteman heard jazz for the first time, he too was captivated by its sounds. Whiteman searched for ways to orchestrate the music to elevate it to the level of a symphony orchestra. George Gershwin's 1924 piece entitled Rhapsody in Blue was originally composed for solo piano and jazz band and was premiered by Paul Whiteman and his orchestra in that very same year in New York's Aeolian Hall in a concert that we call An Experiment in Modern Music. Composer Igor Stravinsky, who we know for compositions like The Rite of Spring and The Firebird, worked with well-known jazz clarinetist Woody Herman to compose several pieces for his jazz band. The most well-known of those is from 1945 and is entitled Ebony Concerto. One of the musicians to most consciously combine and consistently combine the genres of jazz and classical from the 1930s on was the Afro-British composer Reginald Forsyth. His music, which he called new music, was well received by the critics. In this example, Dodging a Divorcee, we can hear the direct influence of J.S. Bach. Now, despite these examples, serious experimentation in the combination of the two genres didn't take place until the 1950s. In a 1957 lecture, Gunther Schuller coined the term third stream, which is now used to describe music that is a synthesis of classical and jazz elements. One of the most well-known jazz groups to experiment with the synthesis of these two genres was called the Modern Jazz Quartet and was led by pianist John Lewis. Now, Lewis believed that the blues and Bach were compatible, and many of the group's ideas centered around the fusing of classical elements and form with improvisation and polyphony. Over the span of their 40-year career, they became one of the most influential jazz groups in history. The composition we're going to listen to is called Concord and uses a compositional technique from the Baroque era called fugue. Now, if you were paying close attention to that example, hopefully you would have heard the melody moving around between the different instruments of the ensemble. Now, I want to thank you for joining me here on the Building Blocks of Jazz. And while we've only scratched the surface of fusing the different types of music together, in this instance, jazz and classical, there are many more things that we can learn and explore, and many more genres that have been influenced by jazz music and jazz musicians. We'll see you next time.